Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I will discuss about an introduction to optimization. If you like this video, then after watching the video, please subscribe the channel. The content of today's video are the introduction, the applications of optimization, then optimization modeling, optimization problem formulation, and different types of optimization algorithm. So as we all know that each and every field, whether that is design, construction or maintenance, it involves some decision making. These decisions may be at the managerial level or some technological level or at any other level. So objectives of these decisions may be to minimize the efforts required or to maximize the desired benefit. These two are the general objectives. So any process or methodology which is involved in these two objectives means to minimize the efforts required or to maximize the desired benefit. That may be the optimization. So process of finding the condition which gives the minimum or maximum of a function. This function may be efforts required or desired benefit. In other words, we can also say that the act of obtaining the best result under given circumstances is known as optimization. So this is a brief introduction about the optimization. Then the application. So every area of our daily life is having application of optimization, whether it may be running a business to maximize profit or to minimize loss or to minimize risk, whether it may be designing a bridge to minimize weight or maximize strength, whether it in aviation industry it may be selecting a flight plan for an aircraft to minimize time or fuel. In civil engineering, it may be designing structural unit. In other manufacturing or constructional process, there may be maximizing benefit or minimizing product cost. In road network designing, finding the optimal path. Or in any other industry or manufacturing industry, the optimal production planning, optimal controlling, optimal scheduling. So these are the some areas which I have listed, and each and every area is having application of optimization. So from this we can say that optimization is very useful in our daily life. So if optimization is so important, then how this optimization can be done? So for this purpose optimization model building is required. And this model building is having five main stages: collection of data, then problem definition and formulation, then development of an optimization model, then validation of that model and evaluation, then model application and interpretation of the results. So data collection phase, this is the first phase. It may be time consuming, but it is the fundamental stage. It decides the success of optimization. It is the availability and accuracy of data may decide the result. Means if data is not correct, then optimization result will not be correct. So that's why it is mentioned that it is a time consuming process, but it is the fundamental basis. So data has to be collected very carefully. Then next is problem definition. So before defining a problem, we need to identify the decision variables. Means what are the variables which decides the output. So this will identification of decision will decide the formulation of model objective. and formulation of model constraints, means when we will decide this, these are the parameters on which output of this process will depend, then similarly at that time we will be able to identify that what are the constraints of the problem. So in problem definition we have to consider, or an optimizer has to consider, that he or she has to identify the main elements which the problem consists. Then also he or she has to identify the number of dependent variables, number of independent variables, number of equations required to describe the system, or number of unknown parameters. The optimizer has to also evaluate the structure and complexity of the model. This is the second stage, and this stage is also important because in this stage the optimizer will be able to decide the parameters on which output of the optimization depends, or output of the process depends. Then after finding the parameters, a suitable model has to be developed. That model may be mathematical description, and that may be a software development. So this model development phase is an iterative process. In this process the optimizer has to change the parameters. If due to some reason proper output is not there, then optimizer will again check the parameters, that whether the parameters which was selected were correct or not. Then after that, next phase is model validation and evaluation. This phase is checking phase. In this phase model is checked, and it is also checked that the assumptions which were taken was correct or not, the performance of model is satisfactory or not. This phase is also iterative process. So this is the general flow chart of an optimization problem. First is the need of optimization, then selection of design variables, then formulate the constraints, then formulate the objective function, and then set up variable bounds, and then select an optimization algorithm, and then find the solution. So this is the general flow chart of an optimization problem. Then design variables. So output of any process depends on some variables. By varying these variables the output can be changed. So first thumb rule is that select minimum design variable. Then if these variables are not selected carefully, then overall optimization problem will be affected with the wrong selection of design variables. Due to this reason these variables should be selected very carefully. Then each and every optimization problem is having some constraints. So these constraints are some functional relationship among the design variables. The nature and number of constraints included in the formulation depend on the user. These constraints may have exact mathematical expression or not. If there is no exact relation, then those are categorized under inequality type. In these are relation, these are having relation like either greater than or smaller than. And if exactly matching, then those constraints will be equality type constraints. So functional relationship should exactly match. Then the objective function, which is the heart of any optimization problem, or you can say that the main objective of object optimization problem is known as objective function. So this objective function is having a mathematical relation between design variables. This objective function has to be maximized or minimized, as mentioned earlier. If objectives are not possible to formulate mathematically, then an approximate mathematical expression can be used. If there is no direct relation, then approximate relation can be considered. On the basis of objectives, the single objective problem may be there or a multi-objective problem may be there. So, multi-objective problems are more complex. So, if due to any reason, any objective cannot be included in the objective function, then that can be inserted in a constant also. Then this optimization function also is having this optimization of your objective function is having the principle of duality, means same objective function can be used for minimization or maximization with the minor change, and this minor change is the only multiplication of minus 1. So next is variable bound. So, setting the minimum and maximum on each design variable is the fixing the variable bounds. Then the types of algorithm, there in general two types of algorithms are there. One is deterministic. These deterministic algorithms are using first principle equations, and non-deterministic algorithms are those in which they are not using any principal equations, they are just known as black box modeling. In this, input and output values are known, and then modeling is done in non-deterministic way. These are the some techniques, deterministic and probabilistic. Some names are mentioned here. Thank you. In next video, I will discuss about the classification of optimization techniques.